Presidential politics heating up, and not just in the U.S. Vladimir Putin as romantic film star. And happy Year of the Rat, everybody. Hey again, Doug Bernard here in the captain's chair at the Download. Now, we had planned to take a break from U.S. presidential politics today. Too bad we forgot to tell the politicians. Bringing us to our latest update, former Massachusetts Governor Mitt Romney has suspended his run for the White House. The announcement coming just 2 days after disappointing Super Tuesday results and Mr. Romney's pledge to remain in the race.
I think there's some people who thought it was all going to be done tonight, but it's not all done tonight. We're going to keep on battling. We're going to go all the way to the convention. We're going to win this thing, and we're going to get to the White House.
Or not so much. The announcement now leaving one serious challenger to front-runner Senator John McCain, namely the former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee. While politicians were busy crisscrossing the U.S. this week, a series of storms swept the American South, leaving dozens of cities in ruin. 11 states cleaning up now, at least 50 killed by tornadoes, that figure likely to grow. As many as 1,000 tornadoes, wow, were spawned in these storms, all but erasing some towns from the map.
The storm shelter that we were in, the top came off of it, and we could see our house flying over us while we were down in the shelter.
Yikes. The twisters tossing cars hundreds of meters through the air and flattening entire buildings into nothing but wreckage. Thousands now homeless. Presidential politics continuing now, but this time not in the U.S. And to Moscow we go. Russians prepping to elect a successor to outgoing President Vladimir Putin. The vote coming March 2nd, but few doubting anything other than a landslide for Dmitry Medvedev, Putin's hand-picked successor. Now, in a twist, European election monitors won't observe the election, saying it's clearly not competitive. Russia's Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov pointedly disagreeing right before beginning preparations for the Medvedev victory party. The next Russian president clearly going to have some big shoes to fill, big manly shoes. After all, when not flying fighter jets, Mr. Putin can often be found showing off his physique while doing a little fishing, or showing off a few of his judo moves. Hi-ya! And now, he's coming to the Cineplex. Yes, Vladimir Putin is the subject of A Kiss Off the Record, a fictionalized film showing the cuddly, fuzzy side of Mr. Putin. Tough day at the KGB, dear? Mr. Putin not mentioned by name, but the movie clearly matching his life story. The Kremlin said to be happy with the film, save for Adam Sandler's rejection of the lead role. It is perhaps an irony that the land that gave the world fireworks, China, in fact bans them from most of its cities. That, however, not stopping millions from lighting off a few Thursday in honor of the Chinese New Year. Celebrations big and small, this would be small, occurring throughout Asia to mark the occasion. Gee, this sort of looks like my neighborhood on the 4th of July. Well, this actually Beijing, residents celebrating the incoming Year of the Rat in big style, with big fireworks as well. These here are the legal kind. Pretty spectacular, too. The dazzlement in the air, hardly a match for Beijing's elaborate stage shows also occurring like this. Coming up, there we go. You know, I really don't have anything more to say here. I just kind of like looking at this. The Year of the Rat in a presidential election year? I'll just stop now. Well, we'll see you again tomorrow.